Welcome to my channel Maths Per Suite. Today under the topic arithmetic progression, let us see what exactly we have in the question. Now moving on to the question, it is given that the houses of a row are numbered consecutively from 1 to 49. Show that there is a value of x such that the sum of the numbers of the houses preceding the house number x is equal to the sum of the numbers of the houses following it. Find this value of x. Now let us see how we can solve this question. Moving on to solution. So guys, as per this question, like this question looks a little bit complicated, but once we understand the question, it is good to go. So let's see. As per the question, it is given that there are total 1 to 49 houses in a row. So let me first put down the things like house number 1, house number 1, house number 2, house number 3, house number 4, okay, and my last house is house number 49. And guys, as per the question, they have given that there is a house, let us assume that there is a house numbered x. We don't know number x which will fall in between this, and we don't know that number. Like they are telling that there is a house numbered x, so let me write here as house number x. Okay, now as per the question, there it is telling that there is a value of x such that the sum of the number of the houses preceding the house numbered x is equal to the sum of the number of the houses following it. Okay, let us try to understand. So if this is the house number x, then the previous house will be house number x minus 1. Okay, and we don't know, in between there are some gaps, we don't know how many houses are there. So let us try to understand this much. If there is a house number x, then the preceding house definitely will be house number x minus 1, that means this minus 1, because if you see this is house number 4, the preceding house is 4 minus 1 is 3. So that is what we will try to understand. Now as per the question, it is telling so that there is a value of x such that the sum of the numbers of the houses preceding the house number x is equal to the sum of the number of the houses following it. Okay, so let us first of all find out the sum of the number of houses preceding x. That means our intention is to find out this value, because this is our house number x and we are just considering the houses preceding it. So sum of the houses preceding house number x, that means it will start from 1 and it will come here like x minus 1. So if we put that in formula, like we can write as x minus 1, because if we need to find out the sum of house number 49, then it should be s 49. Now we are counting 1 to x minus 1, so our sum will be x minus 1. Now let's see, like try to understand the other part. So it is telling, the question is telling like that there is the value of x such that the sum of the number of the houses preceding the house number x. So sum of the house number house numbers preceding the house number x is x minus 1, equal to the sum of the number of the houses following it. Okay, now it is telling like this one is equal to the sum of the houses following it. That means we need to consider the houses from here to here. Okay guys, so how to find out that? So if you see the logic, like let's take the whole number of houses, like sum of 49 houses. If I take sum of 49 houses minus, if I take this sum of 49 houses minus, if I take the houses from here till this house number x, so what I will get, like if I count from 49, and because our intention is to find out the sum of this portion. Okay, so how we will get this portion? This portion is nothing but the total minus this much, we will get this much. Okay, so that means the total is s 49 minus s x we are getting. This is what the question is telling. So we got a equation, or we got a formula, is s x minus 1 is equal to s 49 minus s x, and as per the question we need to find out the value of x. Okay, so let's move ahead and see what we can do here. If you see, the houses are numbered consecutively 1 2 3 4, therefore I can write d is equal to 1, because the houses are numbered 1 2 3 4, so the common difference is 1. and n, the last value of the house is 49, n is equal to 49. And a1 or the first term will be 1. This is what we got from this question. This is the data that we got. Now let us try to analyze this and try to find out the value of each of these so that we can find out this equation or we can solve this equation. Now what is s49? What we will get if we solve s49? s49 is equal to, okay, before we solve s49, let us see what is the formula that we know. We know that 2sn is equal to n into 2sn is equal to n into a1 plus an. Okay, now instead of n I can write 2s49, because my intention is to find out first s49. 2s49 is equal to, here n is 49, is equal to a1 plus a49. Okay, or I can write 2s49 is equal to 49 a1. A1 is 1 here, plus a49 will be 49, because these houses are numbered 1, 2, 3, 4. So because if a1 is 1, a2 is 2, similarly a49 will be 49. So I can write 2s49 is equal to 49 into 50, or I can write s49 is equal to 49 into 50 upon 2. So that is equal to 49 into 25. Or we can write like s49 is equal to, if we multiply 49 into 25, we will get 1225. So guys, we are able to find out the value of s49. Let me highlight this one. This is S49. Okay, now what else we need to find? We need to find the other things like SX1, SX also is required. Okay, now what we'll do if I write, let me use the other formula, what we will get. If I consider AX minus 1, because we very well know that AN is equal to, okay, let me put it like this. First of all, an, we very well know the formula, like an is equal to a1 plus n minus 1 into d. Or I can write ax minus 1, because here our intention is to find out the value of x minus 1 so that we can get sx minus 1. So I can write ax minus 1 is equal to a1 plus, instead of n, my value is x minus 1. I can write x minus 1 minus 1. And the value of d here is also 1. So I can write ax1 is equal to, and a1 also we know the value of a1 is 1. So I can write 1 plus x minus 2 into 1. Or I can write ax minus 1 is equal to 1 plus x into 1 is x minus 2. Or I can write ax minus 1 is equal to x minus 1. So we got the value of ax minus 1 is x minus 1. It is quite obvious, because if a1 is 1, if a49 is 49, then ax minus 1 is x minus 1. Just in order to show you, I did this calculation. Okay, so what we will get if I write 2x, means if I put this formula 2sn n minus 1, where n is x minus 1. Let us put that one. So 2x minus 1 is equal to x minus 1, because here n value is x minus 1, is equal to a1 plus a x minus 1. Or I can write 2x minus 1 is equal to x minus 1 a1. a1 is 1 plus a x minus 1 is x minus 1. Okay, so I can write 2x minus 1 is equal to x minus 1 into, here minus plus 1 and minus 1, it cancels off, we are just left with x. So I can write 2x minus 1 is equal to x, if I multiply x square minus x, I am getting, okay, so we are getting like x minus 1 is equal to x square minus x by, or I can write s एक्स माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स बाई टू. दिस इज वट वी गट एज एक्स एस एक्स एक्स माइनस वन. ओके नाउ लेट अस फाइंड आउट सिमिलरली दिस इज अनदर इक्वेशन वी आर गेटिंग एस एक्स माइनस वन. एस एक्स माइनस वन एज दिस वन वी गट एंड एस 49 वी गट दिस वन. जस्ट वी आर लेफ्ट विथ एस एक्स. ओके सो लेट मी रब दिस वन. सो लेट मी रब दिस वन सो दैट इट वुड बी इजी टू राइट द अदर फैक्टर्स. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट एस एक्स. ओके लेट सी वट वी आर गेटिंग इफ आई टेक एस एक्स. ओके सो वी गॉट एस एक्स माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू सॉरी इट गॉट इरेज्ड. वी गॉट एस माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स बाय टू. नाउ लेट अस फाइंड आउट एस एक्स. सो वी वेरी वेल नो दैट टू एस एन इज इक्वल टू एन इंटू ए वन प्लस ए एन. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर द वैल्यू ऑफ एन एज एक्स बिकॉज वी लेट अस फाइंड आउट वट इज एस एक्स. सो आई कैन राइट टू एस एक्स इज इक्वल टू एक्स इंटू ए वन प्लस ए एक्स और आई कैन राइट टू एस एक्स इज इक्वल टू एक्स इंटू ए वन वैल्यू इज वन प्लस वट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स. एज वी नो दैट इफ ए वन इज वन इफ ए 49 इज 49 देन ए एक्स विल बी एक्स और आई कैन राइट टू एस एक्स इज इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर और आई कैन राइट टू एक्स इज इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर बाय टू. सो गाइज वी ऑल्सो गॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ एस एक्स एज एक्स प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर बाय टू. नाउ लेट अस रिप्लेस ऑल दिस थिंग्स इन दिस फॉर्मूला दैट वी हैव इन प्लेस एस एक्स माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू एस 149. ओके नाउ लेट्स सी. सो एस एक्स माइनस वन वी गॉट एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स बाय टू. एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स बाय टू इज इक्वल टू एस 49. एस 49 वी गॉट 1225 माइनस एस एक्स इज नथिंग बट एक्स प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर बाय टू. एक्स प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर बाय टू. ओके नाउ लेट अस सॉल्व दिस. सो if I want to solve this, let's see what we can do here. Now let me write like x square minus x by 2 is equal to 1225 is nothing but 2450 minus x square by 2. Just I solve this equation because if I multiply into 2 by 2 I will get 2450 by 2 minus x plus x square by 2 which is nothing but 2450 minus x minus x square. So these two and these two will cancel up in our next step. So I can write x square minus x is equal to 2450 minus x square. Okay or in other words let me move everything to the this x factors to the left side. What I will get x square minus x plus x square is equal to 2450. So you could see that minus x plus x it cancels off and we are left with x square plus x square which is nothing but 2x square is equal to 2450 or I can write x square is equal to 2450 by 2. That is equal to 1225 or I can write x is equal to root over of 1225. Okay so if we solve that ultimately root over of 1225 is nothing but x is equal to 35. So guys that's all. That is what the question has asked us to find out what is the value of x. So that means this x value is 35. That means this is the house number 35. So find the value of x. That's all the question wants us to find out and we are able to find out the value of x is 35. Hope guys you understood this calculation. This calculation is a little bit tricky But if you understand the calculation, that then we can easily do it. Like, we need to first of all identify like house number 1, 2, 3, 4, and which one is this x. If this is house number x, then preceding house will be x minus 1. So x minus 1 is equal to, because preceding house, the summation of preceding house will be s x minus 1. And if we do the summation of all the houses, like s 49 minus this one, we will get the summation of this house. Like from after house number x till 49, we'll get this one. So if we subtract that one, then we are going to find out the value of this one particularly, because we are interested more to find out the value of house number x. Hope guys you understood this calculation. This calculation is very easy but little bit tricky. But still, if you have any questions or concerns, please write to me in the comment section of this video. Definitely I will get back to you once I see your comments. Guys, if you really like my videos, please subscribe. If you really like my videos, I would request you to kindly subscribe and also let your friends know. This will motivate me to create similar videos in the future. Thank you. Bye.